I don't have the screen up. It won't come back, so I can't press my to speak button.
Sure.
I know that was planned well, but
go right ahead. Please, Councilmember Barth.
Okay, thank you. Couple of questions on a few slides back that you had where, you know, you did say if there was anything we could change, what would it be? There were some there, though, that were very, very similar that you didn't group together. There were roads and streets and bike lanes and transit, which I would think fell under the definition of circulation. And then if you sort of put those all together, it all of a sudden rose up to over 20%. So I'm just curious as to why you chose what you chose, you know, why you broke out some of those and why you didn't combine some of those.
We tend to try and disaggregate as much as we can because it provides more information, right? So if I combine, say, buses and coaster and bike lanes together, it sort of raises the question, well, how much of that is bike lane versus how much of that is coaster or bus, right? And so for the purposes of relaying the information in a report, we tend to disaggregate them into, you know, the category that we think best captures the comments that were in there. You're right. As separately, you could come back in and say, okay, well, there's a comment here about, attracting new businesses. There might be another comment about economic development together, right? And those could sort of go together. And it's, you know, it's as a reader, you're certainly welcome to go in and do that. But we just, from a conveying the information standpoint, try to give you it at the most disaggregated level we can.
Okay. And I concur with what everyone has said here about us needing to do a survey with our business community. And I know that is something that our city managers actually sort of put before us earlier on, and we had some preliminary budget talks, so I hope that we will also encourage that in the near future so that we have a good understanding as to what experiences they have frequently. They don't live here in our community, or they weren't one of the first people who received the call. And this is great. We know it's wonderful. I wished I could take credit for the sunshine, the beaches, and the lagoons, but I know that, you know, that's stretching it even for an elected official. And the other thing too, with customer service and enjoyment of the parks and everything, I'll go to a park and I might pick up a little stray water bottle left and put it in the recycle bin. But really, this is all about what our staff does here. Our sheriffs, our marine services, our lifeguards, our park maintenance staff, these are the people that the community interacts with even more than the people at our planning department or the receptionist here at the front door. And so, I mean, for me, I'd love to take credit for this. This is what politicians love to do. But the reality is it's the people that work for us in this community that deserve all the credit for the successes, or the vast majority of credit for the successes that we see here. And so I just want to take that opportunity to thank our sheriffs, our lifeguards, our Parks and Rec Department, our maintenance crew, the guys at Public Works. You know, when you turn on the water, I had nothing to do with that. They are the ones that are seeing that that's happening all the time. So this is really a reflection to them. And I look forward to us digging into the business component. Oh, I forgot the firefighters.